Few weeks ago, I introduced in my video Ultimate Hackintosh Build for year 2019, real 14-core iMac Pro killer, and also updated video about it. It was running macOS Mojave. So question of the day, is this Hackintosh build able to run upcoming macOS 10.15 Catalina? Let's find out. Hi, I'm Teresa from Morgonaut.cloud and I help people with Hackintosh builds, Macintosh computers, Linux servers, simply with computers. If you are new here, then please click that subscribe button and hit the bell next to it so you won't miss any of my future videos. A lot of people ask me each day if my 14-core iMac Pro killer Hackintosh build will be able to run also the next upcoming macOS 10.15 Catalina, which should come as always this year in fall, or if there are some problems running it. The only way how to find the answer to this question is to simply try it. By the way, all links, videos and apps mentioned in this video you can find now in this video description. So, I logged onto Apple Developer's website and downloaded the macOS Developer Beta Access Utility. It will allow you to download newest macOS 10.15 Catalina Beta Installer directly using Software Update Panel in System Preferences. Once the macOS Catalina Installer is downloaded, it will automatically open. That's not what we want. We want to use this application only to create the USB installer of it. I've made a video already covering this process, so follow it. Just use updated terminal command for Catalina instead. You can find it now in this video description. Then I just used my already prepared and tweaked EFI folder for my build, updated Clever bootloader to latest one, updated drivers, kernel extensions, some of them I compiled from source to get really the latest versions. Then I just booted from my installer and without a single problem, I installed successfully macOS Catalina on my i9-9900K on Z390 Designare motherboard with Radeon 7 GPU in just about 15 minutes. Copied my EFI folder to my SSD, rebooted, and macOS Catalina latest beta version running on my Ultimate Hackintosh. i9 CPU, 64 gigs of RAM, AMD Radeon 7 GPU. GPU works great. Memory works great. All USB ports are working as they should on advertised speeds. Thunderbolt 3 Titan Ridge controller works great. Both Ethernet adapters works great. Everything like on previous macOS Mojave. So, let's run some benchmarks and see if also raw performance is where it should be. Geekbench score practically same as on Mojave. So let's try Cinebench R20. Here, score on Catalina is slightly higher than on Mojave. Let's run Luxmark to benchmark the Radeon 7 in OpenCL workload. Again, same score as on Mojave. By the way, I tested macOS Catalina and redone all these benchmarks also on my second i9-9900K build with Vega Frontier Edition, and CPU benchmarks are also the same. Overall, macOS Catalina feels a little bit snappier in UI. Some things are still not polished, like here in System Report, but don't forget, this is beta version. For final version, we would need to wait few more months. You don't need to worry about future, my build is ready for Catalina. It is running great already now, simply Ultimate macOS Catalina Hackintosh. If you want to test it yourself or be simply already now prepared for future upgrade, in this video description you can find now link to my latest EFI configuration for this build. By the way, yes, I did it! Tram ta-da-da! I bought the newest Navy card, the AMD 5700 XT for testing, so stay tuned. From my initial tests, 5700 XT is really a nice surprise. So, I hope I made your day again a little better. If so, please click on the like button below. Click also the share button so more people can benefit from it. Subscribe to my channel and hit the bell next to it so you won't miss any of my future videos. And if you would need some help with your computer, you can always get my personal support on my Patreon or Subscribestar. Links are in video description. You can also reach me at my Facebook, Twitter, Reddit or my website. Links are again now in this video description. Morgonaut is always here to help. So that's all for today. Thank you for watching and see you next time, my Hackintosh friends.